running. Thank you for joining us on Facebook.
Good morning.
And thank you for joining us in person. As we begin our time of worship today, let us all stand and sing Joy to the World. We'll sing the first and last verse of Joy to the World.
Shepherds all were watching while sheep in open ground.
Much warmer day than yesterday. It's going to get warmer again. Praise the Lord. And Joni's here today. Praise the Lord. Her family is COVID-free now. Praise the Lord. We have lots of people that we've seen so many answers of prayer. We have a long list of answers of prayer. I tell you what, I like to see that. A longer list of answers to prayer than all the people that are concerned for prayer. And so God has been good. So good. I also know that Sandy's brother, Russell Patty, is doing good now. Last time I talked to him, he was going in pneumonia, and Lord's given him grace and healing mercy, and he's fine now as well. As we go into our time of prayer, what praises or people that are on your heart today?
Chris,
yes.
I'd like to just thank you and give praise for the choir, those members that came out to bless the residents. The joy you brought them, even through the windows, singing was a treasure.
That was a choir did. Sounded like angels. Yes?
What's the update on Ronnie and Harvey?
Can I say?
Or no?
Am I allowed to say?
Chris, I came because I'm not.
Okay.
So anyway, the good news is no goat had fluid around the heart. It did not require surgery to drain that fluid. They were able just to take it off with the needle. So he's out of intensive care, but now he is still on a recovery process for his kidneys, which was the secondary thing that he went in. So he's progressing, but definitely still needs our prayers.
Amen. And he's going to be getting his therapy, and he's going to be doing, believing he's going to be doing real well. Amen. Ronnie also said thank you so much for all the prayers. She's so appreciative. So appreciative.
Chris, Judy Colbert Street went home to Jennifer's on oxygen, and she's doing better, but
keep Judy in prayer. I know there's different people that are over the COVID, but they're dealing with complications afterwards. We need to keep them in prayer. Yes. Yes, Kim.
Don't forget Barb Van Antwerp's brother passed away. His viewing is today and funeral tomorrow. She would appreciate thoughts and prayers.
I definitely keep the Van Antwerp family in prayer. Amen. Thank you. Psalm says this, sing praises to the Lord who dwells in your heart. Tell everyone of love's wonderful deeds. For those who know compassion, remember those in need.
For our prayer song, we'll be singing Silent Night, 103, first and last verse.
Thank you.
special envelopes if you'd like to give, and you can make those out to Brownstown Christian Church. They're taking up a love offering for that family, and some other families be praying for during this season. Let's pray again. Lord, we lift up every one of these loved ones to you. Pray for your mighty hand of healing upon those who have been suffering from COVID or the aftermath. Thank you for the many answers of prayer, bringing so many people through and restoring their health. Pray for the Carmichael family, Lord, that you bless them with a new home in the coming days. And the loss of all the precious memories due to a fire. Lord, we especially lift up Kurt Hadaball this morning. Lord, give him strength and peace and rest and healing. Maybe for others that are online this morning, that there's a loved one or a friend that's on their hearts and mind, Lord, we pray that you know each name, each person by heart, Lord, do the greater work in us and with all those that are our hearts and prayers this morning. Lord, we pray for Judy. You quicken a recovery for her. We pray for the Van Antwerp family and their loss. Lord, as we come through this season, may our focus always be upon your Son, who calls us together as a holy family together. Lord, that you lead us in purity of thoughts and oneness of spirit this morning. That you would always remind us of that we are yours and our lives are in your hand, O Lord. Thank you for all the many ways that people have been generously giving and touching and singing. Father, thank you most of all for your Son, Jesus, who unites us together on this day. We're reminded that resurrection, not death, but resurrection is the last word. Amen. Maddie, we're going to have a special right now from Maddie Gibson.
Thank you.
You'd like to turn with me to the book of Philippians. I wanted to start with Paul's Thanksgiving prayer for the Philippians, which is very much my prayer as well, as being pastor of Bologna Christian Church for 23 years, pastoral ministry for 40 years. Although this may be my last Sunday as pastor of Bologna Christian Church, I'm still always in my heart and always will be a member of Bologna Christian Church, serving any way I can here with you in the future, as well as Hoosier Christian Village. And looking so forward to always just participating in worship and fellowship and all the great things we do as a church family. Paul says this, I thank my God every time I remember you. Oh, how I have so many wonderful memories here. I was just jotting down a few thoughts this morning as I was in prayer this morning, and here were just the first ones that popped into my mind. Thanks for the memories of camping outside with the youth, concerts with Jen and the flute, bouncing houses, water slides, and all the fun rides. So thank you so much. Thanks for the memories of potlucks and apple pie, teenagers and one guy. Being a fool in skits at VBS school. So thank you so much. Thanks for the memories of crosswalks and children plays, homemade ice cream, those were the days. Fishing in the park, going home when it was dark. So thank you so much. Add 100 verses to that. Paul's heart is for Philippian church, is my heart for you today. Verse 7. It's right for me to feel this way about all of you because I have all of you in my heart. This is a place where my children grew up in church. Learned God's word in Sunday school. Lots of fun in the new Family Life Center we built together. In many ways they've served here and with you all as a family, and your families serving with each one of our family. He says, all of you share in God's grace with me. My heart is full because God's grace has overflown, been overflowing in this place. All the wonderful times where we felt like we've been touched by the Spirit of God in worship. Or somebody would say something in communion that would bring a smile or laughter to our faces. I remember the time when I had a man walk in one evening while I was in prayer, and he stood in the back and yelled at me about the loss of his child. And I just put my hand on his shoulder and I just cried with him. There's so many testimonies that we've heard through the years of God's power. We've been known as a church that reaches out to the community and especially the children of this community. But from the other churches, we're known as the church that prays, that sees God do miracle upon miracle, just as the Conrad family has experienced over and over, and so many of our families as well. He says, God can testify how long I long for all of you with the affection of Jesus Christ. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in the knowledge and deep insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until that day of Christ. So many Bible studies, Sunday school lessons. Oh, and who can forget church meetings? We've had a lot of different kinds of meetings with our friends and families and loved ones. Paul goes on to say in chapter 1 of Philippians, he says this, I love this, in verse 18, the important thing is this, catch this, when the scripture says, this is really important, that means pay attention. He says, the important thing is this, that in every way, it doesn't matter whether people do it with the right motives or not, it says that Christ is preached. And because of this, I rejoice. May we continue to be faithful in preaching Christ crucified, Christ resurrected, Christ shining in our lives, our church family, in the churches around us. I praise the Lord for all the new preaching of the gospel that you hear from many different ministers. Bill Everhart next week. Great man of faith, man of God's word, love Bill. And you got some great people coming in to preach. And then he says this in verse 27. He says, whatever happens, it doesn't matter what the circumstances are, whatever happens, conduct yourselves in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ, then whether I come and see you or only hear about you in my absence, I will know that you will stand firm in one spirit. When I came here 23 years ago, carried Kent in a little baby car just like Raph and Tabitha did with my granddaughter this morning. God has brought us through so many experiences and so many wonderful times together that we try to live out the gospel of Jesus Christ, and we've grown together. And I'm sure when I came here 23 years ago, people said, well, in a couple of years, it'll be just like all the rest. Longest pastor I've ever been at, myself, longest pastor you've all have ever had as a church body. That's something to celebrate. All the accomplishments we had together, your generosity, mission giving going up and up and up through the years, paying off the Family Life Center, what accomplishment. Even when our numbers have been down, I've seen the giving go up. It's baffled the leadership here. It's like, it makes no sense. But because of your perseverance, I miss the ones who are no longer here, but you are my special favorites because you have persevered and are here. And that means so much to me and my family. It says in Philippians chapter 2, he says, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any fellowship with his spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being in one spirit and purpose. May the Lord always continue to use each one of us in a mighty way as we serve and live and worship and sing and pray here with one another. If there was a pastoral challenge I would have for 2021, it would be the prayer challenge. Whether you show up here on Tuesday night or whether you just pray more in the quietness of your home or your homes, for those who can't be here or online, or live far away, that prayer would be your dependence upon knowing this, that God can do more in 5 minutes than we could ever do in 50 years. Amen. And because of that, God will continue to do more as we pray, as God's people. And so Ephesians, the last chapter says this, verse 18, pray in the Spirit. Now how often should we pray? Listen to this. Pray on all occasions and with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. You all are always in my prayer, and I pray that you always be praying for our family as well. Pray also for me that whenever I open my mouth, and I pray this be true for all of us, whenever I open my mouth, whenever you open your mouth, that words may be given so that we would fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel for which all of us are called to be ambassadors for Christ. And I pray for myself, and I pray for you, that we would declare it fearlessly as God has called us to do. I don't know if I'm going to try today or not, but I do know this. That it's different this time. Retiring as a minister. Somebody asked me last week, they said, well, Chris, what about preaching and teaching and, you know, and all the different things you do as a minister? And I said, I do them all the time at Hoosier Christian Village. And I'm still going to be with you all here. And that's why I can feel so good this morning, because you're not only in my heart, but I'm going to still be in your presence. Or maybe a day later where the nursing home opens up to where I can preach on Sunday mornings, and that will make it a little harder for me, but we'll just take it one day at a time, as we always have taken it one day at a time as God's people. This is my prayer, that God's peace and love would cover every one of you. That as we've ministered in the gospel of Jesus Christ for these over 2 decades together, may we continue to be fearlessly and faithful to the one who calls us to be one body of Christ, God's people, the church. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for more blessings that I can count. gracious, generous, loving people, Bologna Christian Church, for those that are here in this sanctuary today, for those that are in other places of worship, for those who are before the throne of God, we give you thanks. May we always honor you with our words, that we would proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, and that, Lord, you would give us such a spirit of fearlessness that we would not shy away from bringing glad tidings of great joy that Jesus Christ is Lord and King over us all. Amen and amen. If you'd like to stand with me as we sing together as we say the Lord's Prayer together in preparation for communion. Let's stand. The Lord calls to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
We take those words. We ask the one who loved us so much, even death on a cross, but even that could not hold him dead. So Lord, bless the bread, bless the cup. Prepare us for this holy communion time, and as Jennifer plays, Lord, that your kingdom fullness would shine within us, that your love and mercy would guide us, that you would take us together as a growing family that always looks to you first before everything else. Jennifer plays as you are ready, partake in the body and cup of Christ. Thank you.
to share a couple words. Out of those 40 years, we've been a part of our lives together in ministry for 38, even while we dated. And someone often asked me, did you know you wanted to marry a minister or a preacher? And I said, no, but I had prayed since age 10 that I would marry a man who loved God as much as I did and wanted to serve him as much as I did. And so I always say it took a preacher to match me. So we made a pretty good team, I must say. So it's bittersweet that the word retirement almost sounds like defeat to me, but I'm not a quitter, and of course neither is he. And so we continue our journey together and embrace the village and the love that we get to share there. But I asked myself, if I was to give reflections, where do I start? And it'd have to be the heart. For that is truly what he has, is a heart for God. And just some highlights of the 40 years. He says he was called to ministry at church camp at age 17. And he said, God changed me. So by 19, he was ministering and at college, in a college of for a degree of ministry or whatever it was called, religion ministry. And so he has served many ways in church camps and has always had a special spot, whether that be in Illinois, New Jersey, New York, and Indiana. Whether it be camper or faculty or intern, dean, board member, parent, every which way, vesper speaker in retreats, he's done it all at camp. His first baptism took place at camp as he baptized his roommate from college, and a very special lifelong friendship left there and continued many times over. The baptisms that followed, as he could say, as it does in the scriptures, I don't even remember everybody I've baptized. There's so many that God has brought into his life. So many children and youth of all ages throughout many years of every congregation, even as we dated, we worked with youth. And again, I won't even list all the churches. They're back there on that on the board in that memory table. But always a heart for the youth. There's nothing he wouldn't do for VBS or for the kids. And sometimes I think he was the biggest kid of all. And his knee proves it. A heart for the elderly. From early on, even in Bible college days, we were in nursing home ministries. Every church we served at drew us to minister to the elderly. And especially here, we are doubly blessed to continue that same ministry at Hoosier. He went to jail when he was 19, I believe. And they let him out. But he began a heart for ministry at the jails, even as an early college student. And that heart has stayed true. He's never a homeless or helpless or anyone in need that he wouldn't stop on the roadside and help or go out of his way. And he just never knew who he was going to bring to dinner either. I have some stories I'll tell you on the side there. But always a heart for those in need. Cub Scouts, again, reaching out to the community, to the children. 15 years Packmaster. 20 years ministry in the Emmaus community, which he really hopes to continue and maybe expand as a spiritual director with many walks and many chrysalis flights, those of which our kids enjoy. No better friend you could ask for. A huge and open heart, faithful and true throughout the years and across the miles. And I think there's a few probably watching today. He was once asked by a professor at college, why do you hang out with the losers? You have so much potential, they told him. He's like, well, isn't that what Jesus would do? He always treated everyone the same, and he continues to do so. And even the nursing home residents say that. They're like, you treat everybody the same. Forever a student, a heart for learning, the books to prove it. Many have read, many still being read. Always learning, always growing, always willing to share what he has been taught. And has written a few books along the way and hopes to do more. We'll look forward to that. As father and and family. As he already shared, this is our family. 24/7 he's there and always has been what I call a callback. He gets callbacks throughout the ministries we've served in, whether it be baptisms or weddings or even the passing of loved ones. We've been privileged to watch our own kids grow up here, and we often said to ourselves, no matter how many we minister to, what matters most is the legacy we leave with our children. And praise God, I think we did something right. Or at least four things right. So when I think about reflections, he has always reflected the heart of God. A reflection of God's love for his church. Thank you. No, sit. That's not, you don't get this back. Tiffany wants to share a word, and the family come on up.
I didn't know anything about them.
You were there with me.
Christopher.
I'm ashamed.
My dear friend and brother in the Lord, been a few months.
A lot of months.
A lot of long trips to hospitals all over the state, in Louisville, and here and there, and sometimes getting home at midnight or 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning. Things that nobody knows, and I'm sure there are a lot of other people here that have joined you, and not just me, that have helped you through the long hours of driving to and from hospitals all over the place, and so many things that nobody knows except you and that individual and God. And, you know, we will never be able to begin to thank you for the incredible dedicated service you have given to this congregation, but more importantly, to our Lord. This is a small token of our appreciation for 23 years of very dedicated service, Chris. It says, presented to Chris Criminger upon his retirement as minister of Orleans Christian Church on December 27, 2020, your tireless efforts to serve God and our congregation will long be remembered. God smiled on us for 23 years that you were our minister, it says here, but you're still here. Our prayers will always be with you and your family. Thank you, and may God continue to bless you, the congregation of the Lone Ute Christian Church. And the reason I brought this up here is so I can shake your hand.
Thank you all so very much.
Jay, Bob, Sandy, you can. We would like at this time to pray for their continued ministry and joy in life. Oh Lord, we do thank you so much for the 23 years that we have been blessed with Chris and Sandy. We thank you for the kids, for our privilege of getting to watch them grow up into the wonderful young men and women that they are. Lord, we particularly ask just now your Holy Spirit upon Chris and Sandy and their families as they go forward to continue to minister to you, that Chris, as he changes his hats, continues to be the most blessed and blessing of your Holy Spirit to those that he touches. This we pray in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Amen.
You gonna lead us to the final song?
That's right.